Shout out to you for making us the number one radio station to listen to right about now. Hashtag lifestyle is on your radio, giving you nothing but 100% African music. In the background, I've got Jay Hassa, straight out of Gambia, and this one is titled The Spirit. How you doing, baby? And the atmosphere in the studio just changed. Why? Because I've not only got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people in studio with me. I was riding solo for a bit, but because it's 67 minutes today of the Hassan of Madiba's birthday and celebration, I've got guys who are doing a really cool initiative, Cape Takaro, in studio with me right about now. How you guys doing?
Yo, we're good.
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 Did you just hear that?
Good to be here.
It's like a bunch of dudes just like, yo.
Yeah.
All male voices in studio right about now. I'm actually going to even go around so that everybody gets their 30 seconds of fame to introduce themselves. Should I go from the left to the right? What's the situation? Should we start with Kumuto?
Picasso.
Okay, let's go. Let's start with you.
Picasso.
Hello, I'm Pakumu Makwe. I'm from Pretoria.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm here for the initiative. I'm excited for the trip. Can't wait.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yo, that's a tough act to beat, but you know, I'm Andy Lekunene, half man, half amazing, cool as ice and twice as nice, and I ain't never had a bad day in my damn life. We doing this Cape Takaro out here, baby. We're doing this thing, building these schools now, me.
I love that.
Thanks for the energy. Hey, I'm Tendo Mbabele. From Kempton Park, excited about the trip, really excited. That's me.
And who do we have here? Andrew!
That's me, Andrew Gray, also from Kempton Park, out in the East Rand, representing. Can't wait for the trip to get off underway this afternoon, and all excited for the journey to Cape Takaro and the initiative and everything behind it.
Excellent. Yes,
let's last two. Yeah, okay, I'm Vincent Mafaisa from a township called Sharpeville in the Vibe, and I'm super excited to be part of this thing.
I'm Komutu Siku from a village of Mumubi. I'm also excited to be part of this.
Yeah. So the last two are not from the East Rand, because you know I'm also from the East Rand. So what are you guys doing here?
Yo, we don't all from the East Rand. I'm from Soweto.
Oh yeah, from Soweto. So hey.
PTA right here.
Oh, okay, fine.
Yeah, I love you doing it, but I don't know.
Okay, fine. I hear you. So, tell me about the initiative. How did it actually begin? How did you even decide that we're gonna be those people that are gonna travel for 67 days from the Cape to the Cairo for a really cool initiative as this, and actually explain exactly what is it that you guys are going to do.
So, I'm from the village of Mobi. That's the village we're going to start building the school.
Yes.
So, normally when I go there, the guys would ask, Ekopela Turan. Yeah. You know? So, I didn't want to give them Turan anymore. I just wanted to give them more than Turan, you know. So, I came up with the idea of 67 days to Cairo to raise funds. So, initially, we were going to brand the cars and sell advertising spaces to the cars.
Yeah.
And then we went to Lafarge, and then Lafarge said they could be the brain behind, I mean, not the brain, the sponsors behind the initiative. And then now we're gonna research and go to the villages across Africa.
Yeah.
And then go back, we're gonna have a red, and then gonna have orange, and we're gonna have green. So red means that it's critical, we have to go back to that village in Africa and build a school. And then orange, we know it's gonna take 3 months, and then green, maybe we'll push it back. So we're gonna build 67 schools across Africa using recycled material.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
I think that's absolutely amazing. And I actually wanna bring you guys also within this conversation. Why is it so important for you to be involved in such an initiative, as so many South Africans like love this, and they love the fact that they can actually pay tribute to Madiba this way. But why is it so important to you to be a part of something like this?
I think more than just Madiba.
Yes.
You know, I'm African, my damn self. Mm-hmm. You know, so education is key.
Yes.
You know, at least literacy at the core of it all, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, if we can bump that up and reach 10 kids, 20 kids, you know, that works out better for the whole of Africa, and then equally works out for me.
Yeah.
I mean, so each one reach one, each one teach one. That's what's up.
Oh, I absolutely love that one. Are there any other additional sponsors that are going to be working with you guys within this project?
Besides
Trans Africa Radio, I mean, we are for, you know, Africans, but any other sponsors besides us?
Embassy of Japan.
Yes.
Lafarge.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
about the process of this project, right? So obviously you're not going to get there, build one school in one day and then just leave, and then you know? So take us through the process of it. How is it actually going to work? And if I'm interested at home and I want to donate money to you guys, how can I actually go about doing so?
Okay, so we are available across all social medias like Facebook, Twitter, and stuff. Mm-hmm. If you really want to help us, there's a GoFundMe account we have.
Yeah.
So you can fund and sponsor us over there. But initially, how we're going to do this is that we're going to cross over 12 countries over Africa, and then the whole initial idea is that for us to do research and kind of find out where skills are lacking, since everyone here has different kind of skills to contribute to the trip. You know what I mean? So we'll be traveling, trying to develop our own.
And the 67 schools will be built by 2029.
Is it?
Yeah. So we planning to build 10 per year.
Oh, is it? Yeah. I absolutely love that one. So just the ones that you are going to start with, what are their names and where are they?
The first one is going to be in Mobi Village. That's the village that I'm from.
Yeah.
So we're going to build it in November.
All right.
Yeah, it's going to be Mobi College. And it's going to be a free FET college.
Oh, it's going to be a free FET
college? All of them are free. All of them
Every
are free.
Every school that you guys are building is going to be free?
Yes.
Any school that you're building in Johannesburg, maybe?
I mean, it's 67 across Africa, you know, so, and Africa's 53.
Yeah?
Yeah, so, I mean, we're going to spread them.
We're going to spread them throughout.
Throughout,
okay,
yeah.
So, wait, in South Africa, is your village the one that you guys chose to build the school at?
Yes.
That's where the initial started. And then as we go on, it started growing bigger.
Oh, I absolutely love it. So I'm actually going to get back straight into the music, but when we get back, I'm actually going to let people ask you questions about this initiative, right? +27792544329 is the number to dial. Hit me up right now. It's me, those people that are doing great things on Nelson Mandela's birthday, yeah?
A little.
Video was out as well. Be that person to check it out. T was savage. You gotta get it now, apparently. So be that individual that logs on to www.transafricaradio.net. But nonetheless, hashtag lifestyle is on your radio right about now. Go by the name of Fuzoli. Don't be that vocalist. I gotta blow my own horns. Why am I blowing my own horns? Okay, so why? But nonetheless, if you've just joined us, you're probably wondering to yourselves, who are these voices that you're hearing in studio? I've got a whole group of people because they're doing a great initiative for 67 minutes because we are celebrating Nelson Mandela's birthday. Shall I say anniversary?
Anniversary of his birthday? I don't know yet.
I don't know. Let's just say anniversary, right? So what are you doing for 67 minutes to actually, you know, play your parts within such a great initiative? But hit me up. It's +27792544329. It is at TransAfrica 872 on Twitter, and it's TransAfricaRadio.net on Facebook. And also, I was actually asking you guys, how did you meet one another? And I think we want to hear the story, and as well as what do you guys actually do for a living besides this? So let's start from, let's let Andrew speak first. Let's hear Andrew's voice.
All right, so I'm in partnership in business. We run occupational medicine clinic.
Yeah.
We've got mobile units and a clinic in the East End.
Yes.
The way I got involved in this trip was last minute invite by Tendo, actually.
Yeah.
Dr. Tendo, we've been friends in school since back in, I think, 2007.
Yeah.
So he met up with these chaps at a festival, a musical festival last year, and that's how this whole thing came about. And so obviously the whole initiative of reaching out and getting charity on board to raise funds to build schools, obviously, for education.
Yeah.
I was excited about that and decided, you know, I can't turn this offer down. And that's when I said yes. And that's how I found myself here. So,
and you're like, let me do this.
Let's reach out to those businesses and people out there that are more fortunate than others. And hopefully they can give us some money to take this initiative as far as it can go.
Yeah, and indeed they have.
Yeah.
Moving right along. Next person, I also want to know, what are you guys doing? Yes, what are you doing with your life?
I'm just really trying to score some Beyonce tickets.
That's why you're doing this initiative, right?
You know, I'm a global citizen out here, you know. Yo, Jigga, what's up?
I love it.
Hey? Yeah, that's the business, you know, 67 minutes, 67 days more like it. Guys, it's such a blessing just to be able to do this. So often we want to travel abroad, Europe.
Yes, and now you actually get the chance to do it.
And I've never, you know, had the opportunity to go through most of these countries that we're going to now.
Yeah.
And I don't think I would have done it with anybody else. I certainly would have done it by myself.
Yeah.
So I'm glad to have the backup.
Yeah, to have these guys.
Yeah. I'm glad to have the backup.
And also, you guys are telling me there's doctors in here, there's coaches in here.
Yeah,
who's the doctor?
That would be me.
And how did you meet these guys?
So 2 years ago, I met the pioneers of this great project, Vince and KG, at a music festival in Sydney.
Yeah.
So KG came up to me, we happened to be camping next to each other, and said, listen, I've got this idea to make a difference, a real difference in my community, by building a school. And I think of doing it by traveling Africa and just raising awareness of the struggles that happen in the different parts of Africa, as well as not just the struggles, but the beauty.
Yeah,
shying away from the kids with the flies around their face,
yeah.
Showing the beauty of Africa. So as an academic myself, I was like, geez, I would definitely want to be part of this. And 2 years in the making, they've put in a lot of work. I get a call about late last year saying, listen, remember that thing I told you about? It's actually happening. So then we came together, obviously, to plan something this big, 67 days on the road in a car.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things that come in, so we had to get the couple of minds, people that experience in camping, people that experience in education, because that's what we're trying to bring. And obviously, from my side, the medical side, there's a lot of diseases and things we expect to encounter on the road. Hopefully, nothing too hectic, but that's where I would come in and help out. So definitely, it's an excellent initiative. We're trying to make a very, very big difference in a lot of people's lives, so looking forward to it. Yeah.
I absolutely love that. So, you know, free education in South Africa is a battle that we've actually been having. And most of you have been saying that, most of the people have been saying that free education is not something that we've actually able to achieve. But here's the thing, you guys are saying that you're going to give people free education, right? So how are you going to accomplish that?
Okay, so we're going to be building the school from recycled material, right?
Mm-hmm.
So like your shipping containers, tires and stuff like that.
Yes.
And then how we plan to do it is that the school in the village of Ngovi, like for instance, when they do practicals, they'll be doing practicals to like at a church or a clinic and stuff like that. And at the same time, they're already developing the churches and stuff like that. So how we plan to do it is that it's funded in a way that kids in the villages don't need to have any sort of money to go to college.
Oh, I absolutely love that one. Why aren't people in South Africa doing what you guys are doing? I just don't get why aren't they those people that are actually doing the same initiative so that other people within our country can actually receive free education. So I've got a message coming through from Kiriboni. Kiriboni wants to know, are you going to be helping existing schools to maybe get free education, and will you further develop other schools within the country?
I think the plan is to partner with government institutions because they have the funds, you know. If she wants us to what else did she say she wants us to?
She wants to know, in terms of existing
schools,
are you going to help them also get free education?
We can. I mean, we can try our best, but then we're not promising anything. But then we can help them develop their schools.
Mm.
You know, like we can go and renovate their schools.
Yeah.
And we can definitely
do that. More than anything, this trip is a pilot.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Now we're looking at schools that already the system wants for you to pay and support. That's how it's running.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're starting from scratch, a free
school
and piloting an idea which, if it works, which we're hoping it will, we can then take that prototype and implement it in existing and schools to come, you understand? But now, unfortunately, the reason that system is not working and currently struggling is because the system was set up from the get-go to receive funds for the schools to run.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it's paying for them. Right now, what we are doing is a brand new idea, recycled material, number one, a completely free school from the get-go, piloting it, perfected with one school that we are building in my friend's
village.
Yeah.
And then once we have that prototype perfected, can we then implement it to existing schools and say, this is how we're doing it, this is how we've managed to fund and completely carry on a school without any fees being paid.
Yeah.
And once we perfect what we are doing now, then only can we photocopy that prototype towards existing and future schools to come.
Yeah. I absolutely love it.
And man, look, we're doing this thing, everyone is doing this thing for the first time.
Everybody is.
Mean, so even the challenges that we're going to meet on the trip, we really don't know what they are. I was even saying to my other friend this morning that I don't know, there's no amount of people this thing. You can't say I'm prepared till 100 or whatever. It's just, yeah, you know, as we go, we'll find out. Hence, we're doing this trip for the first time to find out.
Whether it's going to work or not.
You just have to stay united.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, and it's going to work.
It has to work. You don't actually have a choice but to make it work. Yeah. We can't see on you to actually give free education to thousands of students. And let's talk about the media partnership as well, Trans Africa being that media partner. Why did you guys pick us to be your people, you know?
It's in the name.
Trans Africa. Yes.
You know, so we're basically going through the entire of Africa, and you guys reach everywhere from Cape to Cairo.
Literally.
You know, we couldn't have gone with anybody better.
And our trip is mainly going to be in southern and eastern parts of Africa.
Yeah.
So from like South Africa, Zimbabwe, Zambia, Malawi, Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Ethiopia, Sudan, and Egypt. So we'll be traveling mostly from the southeast up until the west. So we figured that, hey, Trans Africa radio station is broadcasting most countries.
So it only makes sense to actually be those people. But nonetheless, you guys are leaving today.
Yeah.
Okay, so from today, you're going to Cape Town.
Yeah.
And then after Cape Town, you're going where?
Botswana.
So that's where the trip officially starts.
Yeah.
And just to wrap it up, right, before I let you guys go, I've got a $1 million question for you. I don't know who's going to answer it. But here at Trans Africa, we play 100% African music. What do you guys think of us playing and giving out 100% African content to Africans?
I love it.
Nothing better than that, yeah.
Nothing better than that.
Yeah, I love it.
I love it.
And how can people follow you guys on social media as well? How, like, I want you guys to put out the social media platforms, the website, everything. If we still want to join, if we want to travel with you guys, can we do so? Can we not?
So you can find us on all across social medias at CPT, the number 2, C-A-I.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's our social media tag. And then Facebook is 67 Days Cape to Cairo.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah. And then we have a GoFundMe for those people who want to fund the trip. We have a GoFundMe account. And you can simply just, you know, donate whatever.
Okay, so I'm just drop rags.
The link for that account is on Facebook.
Yeah, it's on the social media.
Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I hate to see you leave. Trust me, I really, really.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you so much.
We'll give you a report when we get back.
We want to keep up with the.
We're coming back on the 23rd of September, so yeah.
You guys should be at the airport.
Oh, we should be. We're gonna come there with boards and everything.
Yeah.
Welcome back.
Our heroes.
Yeah. And hungry because you guys are busy building schools out there. Sure. But nonetheless, thank you guys. Thank you.
Stay hungry.